not a good night to miss the train, Trent. You have your ticket? Hey, your ticket. You speak English? English? Okay, pay me later. We gotta move out. Bad storm up ahead, it's only gonna get worse, okay? All right, Walter, get us out of here.
Merry Christmas. Kalashnikov vodka from Moscow. Same people make the guns. Do me a favor. Here, go ahead, take it. Blows your hair back, man.
Who's winning now? Rather be somewhere warm?
How much did I owe you for the ticket?
You already paid for it 2 hours ago. Didn't say where you were going, so I just charged you the full fare.
Just a little too much eggnog at the office party.
Yeah. All right, sir. Time to take care of that ticket. Rise and shine, buddy. No free naps on my train. Stroke, maybe.
What? You mean he's dead?
Yeah, heart attack's possible. Maybe from all that running in the cold.
Hey, you know what? He swallowed a bunch of pills when he first sat down. He threw them back like peanuts and then washed it down with a slug of vodka.
Yeah, he took a food pot before he boarded the train.
Hey, you think it was cyanide?
Second off. Cyanide would have killed him right away. Second, Fred's. If you take too much, it'll stop your blood flow and cut off the oxygen supply to the brain. You think you're going to sleep, and then you never wake up. Alcohol speeds up the process.
Wait a minute. How was I supposed to know what he was taking? Yeah, I'm gonna have offered him a drop if I had known.
Anything.
Where are you going?
I'm going to radio here to the next station. Unless you want to ride with him till morning.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, God! Hey!
reflex.
Reflex? My ass. He jumped like he was struck by lightning.
He's dead.
Hey, isn't it bad luck if a dead man looks you in the eyes? No, I read that once where it means that death has seen you and
I'm getting tracky or something.
I don't know where I saw them.
This is a funny looking thing.
Put it back, it's not yours. Hey! You hear what I said?
Yeah. There's a corpse right next to us, and you go back to reading?
Doing?
The conductor told you to leave it alone. What is it? What do you see?
Harry, this is Miles on the Nightingale.
Yeah, we're headed up to Maple Creek, and I need to...
Hang on! What? Just come back to the rear car.
You better get back to your seat before I put my foot up your butt.
Trust me.
Go ahead. See for yourself.
Will
you just look inside? Real? Yeah. See how the light reflects? No imitations can do that. I had an uncle once who taught me how to tell the difference between reals and fakes. And if he were here right now, he would say that they were realer than a nun's tits.
How much do you think that?
Oh, I'd say at least
5,000.
Million.
Million?
Yeah. Depending on the latest pricing tables. Yeah, I already tried that. They're locked in place.
Hey, do you got a hammer or something? That might work. Oh, wait a minute. What are you doing?
I still got a dead man to report.
Maybe we should think about this first before we do something we regret later, all right? I mean, I'm not talking about stealing it. I'm just, all right, maybe we could keep half and then give the other half to charity. Huh? How about the Boys and Girls Club? That's a good group, huh? Look, this is a lot of money in front of us right now. That doesn't mean anything to you, huh, Miles?
Chances are someone else knows he's carrying it. What happens when they come looking for it?
We'll be long gone by then.
I won't. You and her get off this train. I don't.
So quit. Quit your job. Retire. Huh? You get a wife? Well, maybe she'd like to live in a warmer climate for a change, huh?
I can take care of my wife without your help. Or a dead man's.
What if no one knows he's dead?
What did you say, miss?
If the body isn't reported, no one will know he's dead. He didn't buy a ticket. That's why you came back here in the first place. No one will know he was ever on this train.
But he's on this train. My train. What am I supposed to do? Let him rot to New Year's?
One second. So we left Fallbrook and we're headed toward Maple Creek, correct? How much time till we get there?
29 minutes, 16 seconds.
You know that down to the second?
I know everything about this train except his favorite color.
And this is a river.
This is Sturgeon River.
How much time until we cross that?
We cross that in 19 minutes.
Is it wide enough that it doesn't freeze over in winter?
I suppose.
Strong rapids?
I guess so, why?
That's where we can dump the body. Even with the rapids, there won't be any connection to the train. Because it's winter, it'll probably get stuck under the ice and found sometime in spring. All decomposed down to the bone.
Miles? I don't know, maybe she's on to something here.
Yeah, a prison sentence, one I'm not serving.
You won't be connected. You're just the conductor. You've just been doing your job. And he was passed out drunk the entire time. He doesn't know anything.
I was, and I usually am, which is, it's true.
I'm getting off at the next stop. So it's as if we're strangers and we've never met.
Yeah, and it's staying that way.
Miles!
Follow me, and it's your ass that's gonna be dumped, not him.
Years in sales, and I can't convince a working stiff conductor to keep a fortune for his retirement. Oh, did I mention I suck at my job?
Maybe you should try convincing him again.
Well, he's made the call by now.
Can you be so sure what he's doing up there?
Well, what the hell else would he be doing? What? You think he lied? Huh? And he's keeping it all for himself? Stay here.
The only way to get in and out is with my key. I'll grab a wheelchair we use for handicapped passengers.
Right, now we're talking.
We should put him into something, though, so that nobody sees him floating down the river.
We got suitcases and trunk in the baggage car.
Is the baggage car far from here?
At the other end of the train.
Well, we just need to wheel him over there without anybody on the train noticing.
I'll lead the way. Clear path for you two.
How are you gonna do that?
Diversion, charm. I'm a salesman, aren't I? am.
Too close to the edge.
You can't attack him effectively. It leaves you weak in your defenses, okay? Don't worry, I'm gonna help you out too.
Are you all covered with traveler's insurance on your stay here? My company, we specialize in covering tourists such as yourself. Here, check it out. Travel delays. Medical expenses, in-hospital indemnity. You got rental car collisions, accidental death happens, and that's not supposed to be in there.
All right, let's go.
What? Marquesas Islands?
Marquesas todas.
Yeah. You like?
Marquesas Islands.
It's in the South Pacific, right by y'all. Here, let me show you. It's you got Japan. And this is only one island in the whole chain. All of them created by volcanoes. Did you all see me back there kicking ass? I mean, what am I doing in
sales? Check this car. There's an old lady sitting in there.
No worries, okay, Miles? I'm just gonna sweet talk her.
Please be
like
careful.
I did. Don't worry, honey. It's all under control. You know what? My line of work, you gotta improvise all the time.
Is that how you ended up drunk on the train with no idea what stop you were getting off at?
Hey, come on. We get delayed. We missed the bridge.
Relax, okay? I got it under control.
How are you and Poochie doing?
Well, between you and me, we're suffering from a bit of gas, but we're still going to have our midnight meal. Oh, good heavens. What's he doing in my car?
I guess he wanted to take a nap.
Yes, but he certainly does look dead to the world.
A bit too much out of their cheer, I'm afraid.
Oh, dear, that's why I left my second husband, Alfred. He was having too much holiday cheer 7 days a week.
Poochie. Stop.
Poochie, leave the poor old soak alone.
Would you like to switch cars now?
Well, perhaps I better have. Poochie certainly doesn't care for him. I really trust his taste in people.
I'll get your things.
Oh, thank you, dear. Yeah.
Call me Miles.
Okay, how much time do we have?
11 minutes.
This one's the biggest.
Incoming! Tell me you have a bigger trunk than this.
No.
What?
No.
No?
No!
You said that he was gonna fit into something. That's why we brought him all the way back here!
I said there was luggage in the back. Maybe it was unloaded 5 stops ago. I don't know.
Wait, you know all the train routes down to the second. But you can't seem to figure this out!
Packing dead bodies was not part of my job training!
This is ridiculous.
No. Damn it!
Damn, it's not gonna work.
Jackie! Okay, all right, sorry. I'm sorry. New plan. When we arrive at the next station, I'm gonna take him off myself. All right? Yeah. I'm gonna put his arm around my shoulder. I'm gonna just walk him out.
like he's drunk, like he's my buddy, and I'm gonna take him off into the woods or find a garbage dump or...
Excuse me. Steph, what do you mean here?
I was just looking for a washcloth.
A washcloth?
My lenses are dirty. Thanks.
Hey, if she doesn't come back, does that mean she loses her share?
We're taking him back to his seat.
What?
We're going to forget this madness ever.
Wait, what?
Sorry it took me so long.
Yeah?
I had to leave the kitchen car with some gopher.
Wait, what were you doing?
Well? Improvising.
Whoa.
Better be quick. All right. We have approximately 7 minutes before we cross the bridge. All right? Okay.
Stop!
What's wrong, Miles?
What's wrong?
This is all we have to do.
You're about to carve in that fellow like he's a Christmas turkey.
I took an autopsy class last semester. I know exactly where to make the incision.
You're not thinking straight, miss. You gotta clear your head.
My head's never been more clear.
Hey, put down that knife.
It's a meat cleaver.
We're taking him back to his seat. I'm calling in the authorities. It's already been decided.
Do you agree to this?
We didn't take a vote.
Okay, well, let's take a vote.
Right, okay. Raise our hands, secret ballot.
Hey, there's no vote, no democracy. My train is a damn dictatorship, and I'm the damn dictator. So put down that knife, cleaver, or whatever the hell you call it, and return to your damn seat and your damn senses!
All right, Miles. You're in charge. Sorry, Miles. We agreed upon a plan. Not his, not yours, mine. And that's what we're gonna carry out. You can't call the cops now, unless you can explain how he got his head chopped off from having a heart attack. We don't have that much time before we cross the bridge. I'm gonna take care of his arms and legs. You're gonna fit him into the trunk.
I guess this would be the downside of working with strangers. The possibility that one of them turns out to be a psychotic. She's crazy, but she may be right about one thing. We can't call the cops. I mean, there's no way to explain this. You know, she put us in one hell of a corner, you know? You know what? I think it might be a good idea if I take her off at the next station, you know? Find a nice, safe place to bury him. Done. You know? I mean, now that we know that she's not in her right mind.
Are you?
What?
In your right mind.
Sure.
I've seen a lot of bad things in my life. Even in my worst moments, and I always knew who I was.
Well, come on, you're still the same man that you were before.
Everything changed. Inside of that thing.
Yeah. I mean, we're talking about a lot of money here.
taking him off the train at the next station.
What?
Yeah, go home to your family. Sip eggnog, roast chestnuts, put some carrots out for Santa's reindeer, okay?
Miles?
No, Miles is out of commission. Okay, I'm in charge now.
Almost at the bridge.
Forget about the bridge. We're on a new route, and I'm behind the wheel. Okay, now I'm gonna be taking a higher cut. Only fair, right, of course, because now I'm taking a greater risk.
I think we both know who took the greater risk. We're taking it off the train right now.
What are you gonna do? Chop me into little pieces if I do?
Well, I could take something and I could just jam it into your carotid artery. You wouldn't feel anything, and then you'd go to pull it out, and then you'd lose all blood flow to your brain in under 5 seconds.
We got 3 minutes to the bridge. We're finishing what we started.
Miles, where are you? Give me 20, over.
Stole these? I was heading back to the baggage car to save the two of you.
Give me the keys. Get back to your seat. You too.
I'm gonna go take this into the kitchen.
I'll take that. I got it. Go back to your seat.
Oh, God.
Wanted you to know you'll be moving into the nice wing of the hospital soon. Yeah. You know, get your own room there, best doctors. So don't worry what those goddamn HMO people said. What? I'm okay. A little tired. Why you ask? Hey, sweetie, don't worry, really. Why would anything be wrong with me? You're imagining things.
I guess you think I'm a lunatic for what I did back there.
And slice and dice a corpse from time to time.
Miles would have reported him to the cops if I hadn't done it.
Look, you don't need to morally justify yourself to me, okay? I'm in sales, remember? Although I can say I've never cut off a man's head for a commission before.
It's not like I've ever done anything like that before. I'm not a bad person or anything. I'm not a bad person.
I don't know. It's okay. It's all right. Hey, you know what? You did try to save me, right? I mean, if you were truly rotten soul, you wouldn't even made the effort.
Somebody got a hammer in there.
To the station. Come on, we'll have to open this later, okay?
That's my stop. My parents are waiting for me at the station.
All right. Well, give us your address and we'll send your share in the mail.
Hey. No one's taking it. All right?
The box is staying. I'm staying.
What about Mommy and Daddy waiting at the station?
My problem. As far as you're concerned, I got off this train like my ticket says.
What are you doing?
I'm keeping both of you out of view. So I'm locking up this car.
You're locking me in here with her? Now, what's the point of that?
My sanity.
What are you gonna tell your parents?
Nothing.
Aren't they gonna wonder where their daughter is?
I just don't care. And I'm not gonna go back to med school.
Where does life take you from here?
Somewhere far away.
Yeah, I heard that.
But you quit 10 years ago.
That's where you gotta stop when you're young, kid.
Miles, baggage car was open. I mean, it was wide open, you know?
Forget about it. Here's your keys.
You want me to check the hoses?
They'll put this train out the pass the next year. May as well just let it rot in peace.
You okay, Miles?
Yeah. Let's get out of here. I want to see my wife by Christmas morning.
Hey, you know where I'm headed? Marquesas Island, South Pacific. It's where Paul Gauguin spent the last years of his life. You know, the French painter?
I've heard of him.
Yeah, well, he left his wife and kids, life he knew, totally rejected civilization.
Sounds perfect.
Yeah.
You're more than welcome to come with me if you'd like.
Have you started drinking again?
No. No, I haven't had a drop. Here, see? Look at that. And you know what?
What?
I don't even want any. For the first time since I was 15.
Congratulations.
I really do need a promotion. You know how it is, taking care of the family and...
You gotta get another job, kid.
Huh?
You can take care of wife and baby working on the train. Go back to school. Learn about computers, airplanes, something with the future.
What do you mean? You're not gonna recommend me?
The train is a dead end. It's a relic, okay?
I don't wanna be a conductor.
You don't wanna be anything like me.
I wanna be.
Are you fucking deaf? You're not gonna be like me. You're not gonna work on a train. Never.
So what do you say? It's all coming together. I'm free of the booze. You're off your folks. What do you say to a warm climate and a new beginning?
Thanks, but I've spent enough of my life following somebody else's dreams. Do you know what I mean?
I'm frightfully sorry. I haven't got a ticket. The ticket office appears to be closed.
You can pay later.
Oh, no, my good man. I shall pay immediately. Tell me, is the bar on board still open by any chance?
On that for the holidays.
Some dark Jamaican rum would be just the ticket. Perhaps you'd be kind enough to send it down to the rear car. Please, keep the change. Merry Christmas.
Rear car is closed.
Oh, dear. I was supposed to meet a friend there. short fellow. Mr. Cairo got onto the last stop. Couldn't miss him. You don't know where he's sitting, by chance?
No.
You mean you don't know which car he moved to?
I mean, I haven't seen anyone on this train by that description.
Ah. And, no one has left a message or asked me. My name is Mr. Gutman.
Ah.
Well, I shall just have to find him myself. But never mind.
Staying there, was he on the train?
Miles, this gentleman's looking for a friend, a short guy. What happened to that man who got on in Fallbrook? One of his taking pills.
Oh, him. He's who you're looking for?
So he did get on this train?
Yes. No, I mean, he got on board, but he got off again.
He got off again.
He did? No. When? I didn't see that.
He said he couldn't pay for his ticket, so he left before we pulled out of the station.
Why did you tell me this before?
Oh, I didn't make the connection. He coached with so many passengers around the holidays.
Well, we knew since when.
It was my mistake. I apologize.
Should call your friend and find out where he is?
I shall never see him again. He betrayed me. He couldn't help it.
Don't you have his phone number?
Frankie,
or...
finish packing everything in the kitchen.
Okay.
Anything else, sir? I'm here if you need anything.
Miles, a very Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you.
Oh, Pooch is really looking forward to his breakfast. And I'm going to have an apricot brandy instead of tea. But I think it's perfectly acceptable to raise a toast to Jesus on his birthday.
Yes,
don't you?
Yes.
Oh, how lovely. Both elegant and festive. Oh, and look, Poochie. Bacon, especially for you, just the way you like it. Who's a lucky boy? Oh, Miles, by the way, that man's gone. You know the little drunken fellow that Pooch didn't like? Well, he's not in his seat anymore. Do you think perhaps he got off at the last station? Because if he did, I'd really like my old seat back again. The car you put me in's got such a dreadful draft.
A chainsaw with you this time.
Where is it? Give it to me. We'll be cleaning up both of their brains on the floor.
Just reaching for my keys.
Don't try anything clever.
No, sir. I like my brains just where they are. We gotta move to the back.
Well then, move. All of you.
Okay, it's all good.
Is it hot? The sides, are they hot? No. Put it over on the seat. Who else on the train knows that it's here?
No one. No one else knows.
My partner said he was being followed. He asked me to meet him on the train because he feared for his life.
We didn't know him. He overdosed on pills and vodka.
She's telling him the truth.
Well, he was more with pills than vodka, but...
Move back! You're not taking it! It's ours!
That's why you must let me have it. We mustn't waste any more time.
Get out of here!
You don't understand. There are others. I'm not alone.
What others? Who?
Competitors, rivals, enemies. We pursue each other, work together, betray each other, travel around the world following rumors of Slater's sighting. Your lives are at stake.
Please, please, just go! Go!
Anyone who looks inside it will be dead by sunrise. No exceptions.
Look, the only one who's gonna be dead is you if you don't get your ass out of here!
The worst possible kind of death. Death from the inside, the corruption of the soul. If you want to avoid this fate, you've got to let me destroy it. And I know how to do it, too. I have a key. I'll open it, and then smash it into oblivion.
Fine, take it. Destroy it. All we want are the gems inside.
Gems?
Yeah.
Is that what you saw?
Yeah.
Ordinary.
Miles, pick up, pick up! Miles, pick up!
No, No! That's self-defense. He was trying to kill us. That was self-defense because he was trying to kill us.
Christ. Who's gonna believe it? Who's gonna believe this?
It's gonna be quicker this time.
Self-defense. Self-defense.
We'll dump him. Is there a lake or river coming up? What's a G20?
Unscheduled stop.
Why are we making an unscheduled stop?
Oh, God.
We're gonna go up front, install them, and unlock the sleeper. The second door.
What was he going on about? Death by sunrise, corrupting our soul.
He was just trying to scare us.
Yeah. Well, he did a pretty good job at it.
I wish I had never seen those goddamn diamonds.
Diamonds? What are you, colorblind? They're emeralds. You've never heard of green diamonds before.
They're diamonds. White diamonds.
No. No, that's not what I saw.
They were magnificent.
If you want to see them again, you're going to come over here and help me move his goddamn arms.
The trunk hit the ice just as it passed over the bridge. Two fellas out ice fishing said it split open upon impact, spilling body parts out all over the place. Arms, legs, and a head.
What kind of sicko would have done such a thing?
Miles, I'm gonna need to see the passenger list.
Uh,
Okay. Wait here.
Where are you going?
In the sleepers, yeah?
They've been locked up all night.
Hey, why are you throwing my stuff up there with
me? Gotta go up there.
What?
Get up there right now.
No. No, not a chance in hell. Why?
Is your invitation still open?
What?
Marquesa Silence. You and me. You and me?
So who drinks Kalashnikov?
We can't trust Miles anymore. He's gonna crack with those cops on board. He's not like the two of us. He doesn't want it badly enough. It's gonna be you and me from now on.
Well, what do we want so badly? We all saw different things inside.
You don't want it anymore.
No, I just...
You just what?
I'm trying to figure out what the hell's going on here. It's just all so confusing.
It doesn't have to be confusing. Go up there and I'll handle everything. Okay?
How are you gonna save us? Are you gonna pin it all on Miles?
Somebody has to take the fall.
How are you gonna do it?
When you trust me.
Why should I?
You know why.
Two of you left out of the apartment this morning. None of the passengers are staying in the...
Miss? Miss? I'm Detective Melville. I take it you're not Peter Dobbs.
I'd be pretty upset if my parents named me that.
This compartment's supposed to be unoccupied and locked.
I was really tired, so I picked the lock. Didn't know it was such a crime you'd stop a whole train over it.
What's your name, ma'am?
Chloe White.
Says here, Miss White, that you were supposed to get off at Maple Creek.
Supposed to get off? You mean I missed my stop? My parents are gonna go berserk. My mom was cooking this brisket. She's gonna go nuts.
You been alone in here the whole time?
Of course.
So, you always sleep naked in beds that don't belong to you?
Depends on the bed. I didn't want to wrinkle my Christmas dress.
We'll take the interrogations in the dining car.
Interrogations?
You got 2 minutes to get dressed, man. So Peter Dobbs is on this train for 2 hours and you don't get a look at his face?
Well, he's passed out the whole time. I just didn't get a good look at her face.
No, we didn't get a good look at his face, did we, Poochie? Well, he was asleep, you see, when he was in my car. And Miles, that's our conductor, a charming man. He said he thought he'd had too much Christmas cheer.
He was really drunk. Wasted. All these little mini liquor bottles.
Did you happen to notice a luggage trunk?
Yeah, it was an old-fashioned kind of thing.
And did you see if he went to the front of the train at all with a luggage trunk, Miss White?
He left to the front of the train right before I went to the sleeper car.
When I went into the baggage car, the loading door was wide open. Thought it was a screw up at the last station, but if this Peter Dobbs is missing, well, maybe he was the one who opened the door so he could dump the body.
So where is this Peter Dobbs now if he's not on a train?
Marquesas Islands. He wants to go to these islands.
Right.
Met by volcanoes.
Hello? Hey, what's going on?
Sure you bag everything.
Miles, I'm gonna be staying on board the Nightingale. When we pull into the station, the train will be impounded. That's evidence.
Miles, I have a loose air hose. I'm out of tape.
Get me out of this sardine can. Hey. What are you doing?
I need you to go to the baggage car, take all the suitcases, and bring them back to the sleeper.
On the suitcases?
For both bodies.
Wait a minute. He's dead?
It depends on how much oxygen he has left. It's just you and me now. They're looking for his body. They're on a manhunt for him. And when they don't find it, he'll close the case and be in the clear. So you're gonna go get the luggage.
I'm not gonna have anything to do with this.
You wanna see your wife again? I'm all you've got, so go get the luggage. No.
Thank you.
Back up, old man. Back. On your knees.
I confess. I'll confess to everything.
I said, get on your fucking knees!
No!
Great, Miles. Now we have three dead bodies instead of two.
The man was right. We gotta destroy it before it destroys us. We'll both be dead by sunrise if we don't.
Open the floor.
It's gone.
Move! Where is it? Where did you put it?
Maybe it slid to the back. Where's Frankie?
Huh?
Where did you put it? You took it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, come on. I know you have it. You're the only one else with a key.
Miles.
Hey, well, where is it?
It's mine now. I'm keeping the gold for myself.
Gold? Hey, listen to me, kid.
I got locked out.
Hey, what you saw wasn't real.
Yeah, why? For God's sake. That's why you threw a dead body off the train and lied to the cops to keep it.
It was all a trick in your head. There is no gold, no diamonds, no rubies or emeralds, nothing, not a goddamn
thing. Why skip that?
Don't screw up your life over this. Trust me.
Trust you? Is that a joke? You don't trust me to watch over your precious dream, but you trust a bunch of strangers. No problem. I tell you, I got a baby on the way and I need help. And what do you say to me? Get a better job. Well, Mike, fuck you! Fuck you!
This isn't you talking, kid. When you look inside it, begin.
Don't call me kid anymore. Don't call me kid anymore! You're nothing but an old man who's done jack shit with his life. You're a loser. You can't even take care of your own wife dying in the hospital. I'm not going to be anything like you. I'll be able to provide for my family.
Shut up. And you better tell me where you hid what belongs to me. Stop the goddamn train.
Thank you.
止まれ!
Both had to be killed.
Because they were both in my way. The legend's true, it heats up when somebody has to die.
Mugna!
Searching for it for years. Obsessed, just like those others. He'd never used the same disguise twice. Don't worry. I won't kill you. Unless I looked inside it, right? That should cool it down.
Anyone who looked inside of it would be dead by sunrise.
That's what everyone says.
I looked inside.
What are you doing?
I'm going to destroy it. What else? Mr. Gutman said there's a key to open it. And once it's open, it could be smashed into oblivion.
Step away from that sink.
His dead body is still in the sleeper car. The key must be on it somewhere.
Unlike you, Miles. I do my job.
But don't you want to destroy it?
I want my government to check it if I do.
Don't shoot. It's my engineer.
Why'd you come back here?
The walkies are out. Controls are dead. The train can't stop. It seems to run on its own.
Call dispatch!
There's no radio, no phones.
We're being diverted to a dead end track. We're gonna crash.
Over here.
Attach the coupler with a crowbar. We gotta do it now, fast.
Hello, Miles. That old lady should have known better. When you fire at someone, you should hit a vital organ.
Preferably the brain.
It wants us to kill each other. Why should we let it win?
It'll kill you, maybe. But never me. I'm the one it's been searching for all these years. I'm the only one that it really wants. Why do you think it protected me from that bullet? Huh? It loves me. It really loves me. And I love it.
Thank you.